Students, today we'll be starting with a new chapter, the second chapter, Pythagoras theorem. Now when you think of Pythagoras theorem, you are learning this chapter from 7th standard, right? So this chapter, in this presentation, will be having recall part, that is what you have learned till 9th standard. Yes, 7th standard you had learned Pythagoras theorem, Pythagoras formula, right? Even in 8th standard and again in 9th standard. So let me see what you remember and what all things are continued in this chapter. So first, when we talk about Pythagoras theorem, we have this theorem with us. In a right angle triangle, the square of hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the square of remaining two sides. Means when I'm talking about any triangle, say triangle is given PQR, where PQR is 90 degree, that is angle Q is 90 degree, I will say side, opposite side, it is hypotenuse side equal to length of PQ square plus other side, that is length of QR square. Now till here you were using length LPR square. Now in this chapter you can avoid using length, you can start directly with PR square, that is hypotenuse square, equal to one side square plus other side square. You are very well familiar with this theorem, I hope you remember. After Pythagoras theorem, we'll be going to Pythagorean triplet. Now Pythagorean triplet is nothing what you have already studied before, it's same thing. It states that in a triplet of natural numbers, if the square of largest number is equal to the sum of square of remaining two numbers, the triplet is called Pythagorean triplet. You know it very well, sum of two numbers. Triplet means numbers which are in three, that is three numbers are given to you. Out of these three numbers, whichever number is bigger, say 3, 5, 4, 5 is bigger, the square of 5 is equal to the rest two numbers, say 3 and 4 squares. Okay, so this is called as Pythagorean triplet. Now let me see how to solve these sums. Okay, let me see the example sums. You have to verify here that 3, 4, 5, 5, 12, 13, 8, 15, 17, 24, 25, 27 are Pythagorean triplet or not. Okay, to identify this, first my step will be to find out the biggest number out of the given question. So first let me take 3, 4, 5. Okay, so when I'm taking 3, 4, 5 is the greatest number, it is the biggest number. So 5 square equal to 25. What are the rest two numbers? 3 and yes, 4. The square of 3 plus 4 square equal to 9 plus 16 is equal to 25. Now very important thing is the third one. Therefore, third line. Therefore, 5 square is equal to 3 square plus 4 square. I think I must give you a proper thing that when you are writing this sum, you know the sum very easily. A small mistake which every student normally do it, this third line, they write it at first only. So first only when you are proving it, 5 square is equal to 3 square plus 4 square, again when you are proving single numbers, that is 5 square, 3 square, 4 square, it means first line is only wrong. So while looking your first sum, even though your answer is right, because of your first line, we will give you whole answer is wrong. Because your first line only states that they both are equal. Are you understanding? So be very clear, write single number. If you are not able to write 3 square, 4 square adding, it's okay. Write biggest number 5 square equal to 25, then 3 square equal to 9, 4 square equal to 16, then come 3 plus 9 plus 16 equal to 25. So 25 and 25 are equal, therefore 5 square equal to 3 square plus 4 square is a Pythagorean triplet, that is 3, 4, 5 is a Pythagorean triplet. Okay, take single number will also do, but don't write the third line, that is the important line that proves that they both are equal. Don't write on the first line itself stating that it is a Pythagorean triplet. Okay, so be very clear with this step. People, students normally do same mistakes. So let me start with the second sum, 5, 12 and 13. Out of this, which is the biggest number? Yes, 13. So 13 square is equal to 169. 12 and 5 are left. So 5 square plus 12 square equal to 25 plus 144 will give you 169. Are they both equal? Yes. So I will say yes. 13 square equal to 5 square plus 12 square equal to 169, right? Both answers are right. Therefore, 5, 12 and 13 is a Pythagorean triplet. Don't do the spelling mistake. And final statement is compulsory to write. Whether you are, it's a Pythagorean triplet or not. Writing equal to and putting that they both are equal is not sufficient. Final statement is important. So now let me move to the third one. Your 17, 8 and 15 are given to you. Right? When I'm talking about this, again, which is the greatest number? 17. So 17 squared is equal to 289. 8 square equal to 64. 15 square equal to 225. That gives you 289. Therefore, I can say 17 square and the remaining two sides, that is 8 square plus 15 square, the answers are same. Therefore, it's a Pythagorean triplet. I hope you understood how to solve it. Okay, this all example sums you have to solve in your notebook. The statement which I gave you before, what do you mean by Pythagorean triplet, or what I told you about Pythagoras theorem, you have to draw with the diagram. Okay, so whatever is given in the presentation, you have to write. Now let me come to the fourth sum, 25, 7 and 24. Again, greatest number square is equal to rest two numbers, that is 7 square plus 24 square. That will give you 49 plus 5, 76. About 25 square is 625, and adding of these two numbers also give me 625. Right? So I will say both are equal. Therefore, 25 square equal to 7 square plus 24 square. And final statement is important. Now when I talk about this sums, 2.1 first sum is given to you in this form only. This type of sums come for 2 marks and here each step consists marks. So the sums are very easy. You know it this thing previously also. But how to write is very important. The steps are important. If you write one step, second step on the third step and the third step on the last, on the second place, so it will be completely wrong. So step wise you have to write the answer. I hope I am very clear. Okay, now let me move on to let's recall part what you have learned till yet in 9th standard. In 9th standard you have learned 30, 60, 90 theorem and 45, 45, 90 theorem. You just recall it what we have learned. It's same what you have studied in 9th standard. Nothing different. So to find a side opposite to 30 degree, to find a side opposite to 60 degree, and when CB is given as an hypotenuse, right? How to find? Say I have given your triangle ABC. Here I have given angle A is 90, angle B is 60, and C is 30. Then what will be my AB? Yes, AB is opposite of 30. It will be half into hypotenuse, right? And what will be your AC, that is opposite to 60? Root 3 upon 2 into hypotenuse. Okay, don't think that the sum is easy, because what happened, you by chance or by you know that you feel that I am confident, I know the answer, and instead of AB you write BC, and instead of BC you write AB, the whole answer is wrong. So to find the opposite side, you have to half into hypotenuse. Okay? And opposite of 60, it will be root 3 upon 2 into hypotenuse. Now, let me move to the 45-45-90 theorem. It's an acute angle triangle where it has been given that the acute angle of a right angle triangle are 45 and 45, then each of the perpendicular side is, to find the side opposite to 45 is 1 upon root 2 into hypotenuse. And again you can see there are 245, so two opposite sides. That is, if I see the diagram, I can say AB, to find side AB as well as to find BC, I have to do 1 upon root 2 into hypotenuse. Okay, you can make a note of it in your book. 30 equal to what, 60 equal to what, and 45 equal to what. You have to make a note so that whenever you go, you don't have to read the definition or anything, you just know it very well. Yes, root 3 1 upon root 2 into hypotenuse, that is for 45. Okay, so now let me move on to the example sums related to this, which are already given in your textbook. First example sum, figure 2.11, in triangle ABC, B is 90 degree, angle A is 30 degree, AC, that is hypotenuse, given as 14. Then they have told you to find side opposite to 60, that is AB, and side opposite to 30, that is BC. Okay, so shall I start? In triangle ABC, I will say B is 90, A is 30, and C is 60 degree. Okay, by 30, 60 theorem, you have to write which theorem you are using. So by 30, 60, 90 theorem, I will say BC is half of hypotenuse, that is half into AC. That is half into AC is 14 given to you. So half into 14 gives you 7. Okay, only they have told you BC, then we'll move to AB. AB is nothing but opposite to 60 degree. That gives you root 3 upon 2 into hypotenuse. Root 3 upon 2 into hypotenuse is 14. So 2 and 14, that gives you 7 root 3. Okay, I hope you know the cancellation very easily. You know it very properly how to do. So you got the answer BC and AB. That much, that is only asked to you. Second sum states that it's given that in triangle ABC, AD is perpendicular to segment BC. Okay, C is 45 degree, BD is 5, AC is 8 root 2, then find AD and BC. The whole BC you have to find. Okay, so for here I will say, let me state all the things which are given to me in this question. So I will say, in triangle ABC, angle D, that is angle ADC, is 90 degree, angle C is equal to 45, and DAC is equal to 45. Therefore by 45, 45, 90 theorem, I can say AD is equal to DC equal to 1 upon root 2 into hypotenuse. That is 1 upon root 2 into 8 root 2. AC is your hypotenuse. Okay, so your root 2 will be cancelled. So your DC is 8. Now once you get DC, you have BD. Can you find whole BC? Yes, I can say B dash D dash C. Therefore BD plus DC equal to 5 plus 8, that gives you 30. See, you're writing the theorem, which theorem you are using is important. I hope you understood this. Now till yet, whatever we have learned, it's all recall part. That is, we have learned Pythagoras theorem, we learned Pythagorean triplet, we learned 30, 60, 90, we learned 45, 45, 90. This all you knew it till 9th standard. Now let me move on to new two theorems which are there in this chapter. Now first theorem is theorem related to similarity and right angle triangle. So what this theorem states, in a right angle triangle, if altitude is drawn to the hypotenuse, then the two triangle form are similar to the original triangle as to each other. Now you have to prove that the triangle drawn are all three ways. The triangle which you can see or you can write in the three ways, they all are similar to each other. So what is given to you will say, in triangle ABC, I will say angle B, that is angle ABC is 90 degree. BD is the perpendicular to AC, A dash, D dash, C. Now to prove here, see how to take a triangle. First take a smaller triangle and then bigger triangle. Another smaller triangle, then bigger triangle. Okay, and then the third one, I will take both the two smaller triangles. So I am stating once again, first I will take smaller triangle and bigger triangle to prove it they both are similar. That is, I will be taking first ABD, see the diagram, ABD and triangle ABC, that is the bigger one. Okay, second I will take triangle BDC and triangle ABC, bigger one. Now I will take both the smaller triangle, leaving the bigger one, that is triangle ADB and triangle BDC. I will prove that they both triangles are similar. So how to prove? First I will go with the first one, that is ABD, ADB and triangle ABC. Okay, so here I will say, your A is common in both the angles, that is both the triangle common angle is A. Even B, and in triangle ABC B, in first triangle D is 90 and in second triangle B is 90, so each angles are 90, therefore by AA test I can say both triangles are similar. I hope you understood how to prove. Again I am repeating, in first and second triangle, that is ADB and triangle ABC, DAB is common into BAC, common angle, A is common, and D and B each are 90 degree, therefore both triangle are similar by AA test of similarity. Now we will take second triangle, that is triangle BDC and bigger triangle ABC. Again I will say, in this both the triangles C is a common angle, and angle D and B each angles are 90 degree, therefore both triangles are similar by AA test of similarity. Okay, now here when you see this, when this is for transitivity, that is one triangle is congruent to second and second is congruent to third, that is one is similar to second and second is similar to third, I can say first is also similar to third, right? Therefore from 1, 2 and 3 I can say, that is triangle ADB is similar to triangle BDC from 1, 2 and 3. So I will say all three triangles are similar to each other. Hence we prove what we have been given to prove. Okay, now related to this, we have another theorem, that is theorem of geometric mean. Now this theorem states that in a right angle triangle, the perpendicular segment to the hypotenuse from the opposite vertex is the geometric mean of segment into which the hypotenuse divided. It means I have to prove that QS is the square of PS into SR. Okay, so here I will say, here it is given that triangle PQR is a right angle triangle, okay, where Q is 90 degree. QS is perpendicular to hypotenuse PR. Here already I can say by seeing this diagram, previously we have proved similar diagram, that both triangle, the smaller triangles are also similar by the previous theorem. So directly I will write that QSR is similar to PSQ. Why? Similarity of right angle triangle theorem, which we proved within before 2 minutes, right? Once we prove that both triangles are similar, we'll write in the form of corresponding sides. So QS upon PS equal to SR upon SQ. Instead of SQ I can write QS also. Okay, so you can see both have equal to sign. Once I write equal to sign, I can cross multiply, that is QS into QS, PS into SR, it will be cross multiplied. So I will get the answer as QS square is equal to PS into SR. Therefore, I can see QS is the geometric mean of segment PS and SR. Okay, this theorem is very easy. Geometric mean states that perpendicular drawn from the point that is 90 degree is square of opposite, the side which we have formed is a square, that is PS into SR, and QS is the square of it. Okay, so by this we have completed the theorem. First theorem we have completed similarity of right triangle, and second geometric mean. Now let we have a look on a some example sums related on this. Now let we have a look on the example sum. We have already completed example number 1 and 2, and this is the third one. 1 and 2 was related to 30, 60, 90 and 45, 45, 90. Of your textbook you can refer. Now this is example 3 in your textbook. So let we have a look. Triangle PQR is given to you, in which angle PQR is 90. QN is perpendicular to PR. PN is given as 9. NR is given as 16. You have to find QN. So to find this, I will write in triangle PQR, segment QN is perpendicular to PR. Because of theorem which we have learned, we will write here theorem of geometric mean states that NQ square is equal to multiplication of opposite, that is a hypotenuse side, that is PN into NR. Okay, so this is very easy sum. Square will go over there, will become square root, that is square root of PN into NR. 9 square root is 3 and square root of 16 is 4. 3 into 4 is 12. Okay, so by this we got the value of NQ. See the sum, it's very easy, right? You can see here only you have to do the square root of the numbers which are given to you. Okay, now let me move on to exercise 2.1. Now till yet we have completed lot of things. Now related to that, whatever sums are there in 2.1 will first complete it. So I have taken here 2.1, you have to taken here first one. Identify which one of the following are Pythagorean triplet. There are almost 6 questions, out of which I have taken 2. And when you go through with that question, some questions are already been solved in this presentation in the form of examples. So I have taken which I felt which are little difficult one. Okay, so I have taken the fourth one. 74, 24 and 17. For this type of sum, you must know how to square the numbers easily. So 74 is the greatest number. So I will say 74 square is equal to 5476. 24 square is 576. 70 square is 4900. Adding of 576 plus 4900 will give you 5476. Right? So are they equal? Yes. So I will say 74 square equal to 24 square plus 70 square is, yes, I will say 24, 70 and 74 is a Pythagorean triplet. Okay, the sum is very easy. You must know how to square the numbers. Now let me move to the fifth one. 27, 10 and 24. 27 is the greatest number, so 27 square is 729, 10 square is 100, 24 square is 576. 729 and 676, they both are not equal. So here I will say 27 square is not equal to 10 square plus 24 square. Therefore, 10 square comma 24, 10 comma 24 comma 27 is not a Pythagorean triplet. Okay, this is the question where it's not a Pythagorean triplet. You have to be very careful while doing the squares of any numbers. Okay, now this we have completed the question number 1. Now let me move to the question number 2. क्वेश्चन नंबर टू स्टेट्स दैट इज अ ट्राइंगल एम एन पी वेर एम एन पी इज इक्वल टू 90 डिग्री. सेगमेंट एम क्यू इज परपेंडिकुलर टू सेगमेंट एम पी. एम क्यू इज गिवन एज 9, क्यू पी इज गिवन एज 4, एन क्यू यू हैव टू फाइंड. ओके, दिस इज सिमिलर वॉट वी हैव सॉल्व इन द एग्जाम्पल्स. सो फर्स्ट स्टेप विल बी वॉट इज गिवन टू यू इन द क्वेश्चन, यू हैव टू राइट इट फर्स्ट. दैट इज, इट इज गिवन दैट ट्राइंगल एम एन पी वेयर एंगल एम एन पी इज इक्वल टू 90 डिग्री, एन क्यू इज परपेंडिकुलर टू एम पी. ओके, सो योर थियरम ऑफ ज्योमेट्री मीन्स स्टेट्स दैट एन क्यू स्क्वेयर इज इक्वल टू एम क्यू इंटू क्यू पी. विच टू नंबर दिस सेगमेंट यू हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई, यू हैव टू बी वेरी केयरफुल. नाउ स्क्वेयर विल गो ओवर देयर, विल बिकम स्क्वेयर रूट. सो स्क्वेयर रूट ऑफ एम क्यू इंटू क्यू पी, दैट इज स्क्वेयर रूट ऑफ 9 इंटू 4 इज 3 इंटू 2. सो एन क्यू इज 6 यूनिट्स. आई होप यू अंडरस्टैंड. नाउ दिस टाइप ऑफ सम इज वेरी ईजी. यू हैव टू ओनली फाइंड द यूनिट ऑफ पर्टिकुलर गिवन सेगमेंट, दैट इज एन क्यू. सो यर वेन यू आर राइटिंग द सिंगल नंबर, राइट इन यूनिट्स फॉर्म, दैट इज 6 यूनिट. नाउ लेट वी मूव टू द थर्ड सम. थर्ड सम इज अगेन रिलेटेड टू ज्योमेट्रिक मीन. 290 डिग्रीज आर गिवन टू यू. यू कैन सी अ परपेंडिकुलर ड्रॉन फ्रॉम पी एम टू क्यू आर. ओके, लेट वी हैव अ लुक ऑन द क्वेश्चन. ट्राइंगल इज गिवन क्यू पी आर वेयर क्यू पी आर इज इक्वल टू 90 डिग्री, पी एम इज अ परपेंडिकुलर टू क्यू आर, एंड क्यू डैश एम डैश आर इज गिवन टू यू. पी एम इज 10, क्यू एम इज 8. यू हैव टू फाइंड क्यू आर. ओके, सो फर्स्ट स्टेप विल बी टू वॉट एवर इज गिवन इन योर क्वेश्चन, यू विल राइट इट फर्स्ट. दैट इज ट्राइंगल पी क्यू आर इज इक्वल टू इन ट्राइंगल पी क्यू आर आई विल से एंगल क्यू पी आर इज इक्वल टू 90 डिग्री, एंड सेगमेंट पी एम इज परपेंडिकुलर टू सेग क्यू आर. देयरफॉर बाय थियरम ऑफ ज्योमेट्रिक मीन आई विल से पी एम स्क्वेयर इज इक्वल टू क्यू एम इंटू एम आर. ओके, सो 10 स्क्वेयर इज इक्वल टू 8 इंटू एम आर. क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाइड एज इट इज अ मल्टीप्लीकेशन साइन, इट विल गो अवर देयर विल बिकम डिविजन. सो 10 स्क्वेयर इज 100, 100 अपॉन 8 दैट गिव्स यू 12.5. नाउ यू हैव एम आर, कैन यू फाइंड होल क्यू आर नाउ? येस, दैट इज ऑलरेडी गिवन टू यू क्यू डैश एम डैश आर. सो आई कैन से क्यू आर इज नथिंग बट माई क्यू एम प्लस एम आर, दैट इज 8 प्लस 12.5. सो 8 प्लस 12.5 गिव्स यू 20.5 यूनिट्स. आई होप दिस आंसर इज अगेन वेरी ईजी फॉर यू ऑल. ओके, यू विल बी एबल टू सॉल्व इट वंस यू अंडरस्टैंड द ज्योमेट्रिक थियरम, ज्योमेट्रिक मीन थियरम. नाउ लेट मी मूव टू द फोर्थ सम. फोर्थ सम यू कैन सी 30 डिग्रीज गिवन, 90 डिग्रीज गिवन. सो लेट वी हैव अ लुक. फाइंड आर पी using the information given in the triangle PSR. So what you can see in the diagram, I can see a triangle with 90 degree. One is 30, so remaining will be, but obvious, 16. So 30, 16, 90 theorem I'll be using, and you have to find RP and PS. It is PS is opposite to 60 and RP is opposite to 90, that is hypotenuse. So here I will start. What is given to you? I will say a triangle PSR is given where S is 30, 90 is S, P is 30, S is 90, and remaining R is 60. To find PS, I will say half into hypotenuse, that is 6 RS is given as 6 equal to half into RP. Cross multiply, you will get the hypotenuse, that is RP. That is RP is 6 into 2 equal to 12 units. Write it down very clearly, theorem of 30, 60, 90. Okay, now let me move to find PS. How to find PS? It's nothing but root 3 upon 2 into hypotenuse. It is root 3 upon 2 into 12 gives you 6 root 3 units. Okay, 6 root 3, I hope you know, 2 and 12 will be cancelled. So 2 ones are, 2 6 are, so 6 root 3 units. So here write the final answer, that is RP is 12 and PS is 6 root 3 units. So very clear what you are writing at the final. Final statement consists marks. Now let me move to the fifth question. Here it's an activity based question. So let me have a look. For finding A, B and B, C with the help of information given in the adjoining figure, complete the following activity. Here they have given an activity based question. Wherever the given box is there, you have to fill it. But before filling the box, there are some steps. So you have to do it. Okay. So let me see. A, B and B, C are given as an equal. Okay. So I can say in triangle A, B, C, when A, B and B, C are equal, it's an isosceles triangle theorem. The angles are also equal. Right. So how to find the other angles? That is, one is 90. So yes, sum of the measure of an angle of a triangle is 180. Right. So angle A plus B plus C is equal to 180. Instead of C, I can write A from equation 1. So A plus B plus A is equal to 180. That is 2A plus 90 equal to 180. So 2A is equal to 90. So I can say angle A is equal to 45. If angle A is 45, then my angle C is also 45 degree. Now the actual box, that is activity, starts. So first box is, what is the measure of angle BAC? I will say, right now only we found BAC is equal to 45 degree. Now next says, AB is equal to BC, then what will be your value of AB and BC? I will say it's opposite to 45 degree. Both will be equal, that is 1 upon root 2 into hypotenuse. That is theorem of 45, 45 and 90. Okay. So what is the value of AC given to you? Root 8. Root 2 and root 8, when I talk about 8, root 8 can be written as 2 root 2. Now 2 root 2 divided by root 2, root 2, root 2 will be cancelled. 1 into 2 will be your final answer, that is 2 units. So I will say therefore AB is equal to BC equal to 2 units. You can see this, all are the box given to you and you have to fill this box. Okay. So this is an activity based questions. So till yet we have completed Pythagorean triplet, property of 30-60-90 triangle, property of 45-45-90 triangle, similarity and right angle triangle, theorem of geometric mean. We have solved the sums related to 30-60-90. We have solved the sums related to 45-45-90. We have solved the sums theorem of geometric mean. Till yet we have completed 2.1, question number 1 to 5. I hope you understood it and you will be able to solve these sums in your notebook. Okay, so meet you again with the next presentation. Thank you, students.